you can add color to your websites using CSS. However, in order to do this, you first need to understand how color is encoded. To start, color is composed of light. All light, including the light being emitted from your screen right now, is composed of a certain proportion of red, green, and blue light. The amount of red, green, and blue light is what determines the color you see. For example, the combination of red and green light with the absence of blue light is what makes the color yellow. The combination of green and blue light with the absence of red light is what makes the color cyan. And there are countless variations in between. The different combinations of red, green, and blue light make up 16,777,216 colors. That's a lot of colors. When writing CSS, you express color by specifying the amount of red, green, and blue light that should be present. This can be done in one of two ways. In the first way, which is commonly referred to as RGB, each amount of red, green, and blue light is written as a decimal number between 0 and 255. 0 being the lowest value or no presence of light, and 255 being the highest value or 100% presence of the light. For example, if I wanted to change the background color of this page to magenta, then I'd write background color RGB 255 0 255. The first 255 specifies red light, the 0 specifies green light, and the second 255 specifies blue light. The combination of these values produces magenta. In the second way, which is called hexadecimal, or hex for short, each amount of red, green, and blue light is written as a hexadecimal number between the values 00 and FF. 00, which is just 0 in decimal, and FF, which is just 255 in decimal. If you're unfamiliar with how hexadecimal works, check below for some helpful links. Using the same example for magenta, I would instead write background color, a pound sign, this tells the browser I'm using hex code, and then FF00FF. The first FF, which is really just 255 in decimal, specifies red light. 00, which is just 0 in decimal, specifies green light. And the second FF, which again is 255 in decimal, specifies the blue light. This encoding also produces the color magenta. Now, colors aren't always as straightforward as primary and secondary colors. Like I said, there are millions of different colors you can express using CSS. Often, what can be helpful is using a color picker to get the exact shade, tint, and tone for the color you're trying to use. You've probably seen a color picker before if you've ever used a graphics or design tool, but did you know that most browsers actually come with their own built-in color picker? Check it out. Here I have Google Chrome opened and I'm looking at BBC's website. If I inspect the navigation bar and try changing the background color, you can see that by clicking on the color square, I open Google Chrome's color picker. With the color picker, I can use the eyedropper to select another color on the screen. I can change the hue by dragging the slider. I can select a color, and I can toggle between the hex and RGB encodings of the color.